Fitting in is the opposite of belonging.
What do you say, Lewis? Wanna be a Robinson?
People connect with who you are, not the front you put up.
Who you are is a perfect fit for a certain family.
I'm so sorry.
You failed!
And it was awesome.
You bring value to the table. As long as you see it in yourself, once you become more self-assured, then that gets projected out more, and then more people get attracted to it.
I'm gonna give you the controls.
Bryson,
take the wheel.
Take it from my hand.
Oh my gosh. Did we just become best friends?
Yes.
Hello and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Alan Seawright, a professional filmmaker who needs therapy. Way over there is...
Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies. And joining us today, a very special guest...
is me.
Bryson.
Me. I love me.
Bryson from Haminations. So for those who don't know, which I'm sorry if you don't know, Bryson is the creator of Haminations, an incredible YouTube channel. Really funny. I say my kids love it, but I love it as much as my
kids.
Yeah,
I watch it with my kids, and I'm not mad about it.
Yes.
So
yes.
High praise.
Yes, man. It is. That I really appreciate that, because that's like, I forgot who said it, but it was like a children's story that can only be enjoyed by children is not a good children's story
yes.
in the slightest.
Yes.
I forgot who said it, but...
It was you just now. You were taking credit
yeah,
for
I'm
it.
Taking credit yeah. for it.
So what are we doing so today, Alan?
What are we doing today, Bryson? Because you actually, you got to pick the movie that we're talking about
so,
that Jonathan, our therapist, is going to react to.
Yeah, so we're doing Meet the Robinsons, another quirky blonde boy. I'm very... Real recognizes real, guys. I see him. I understand him.
Didn't you dress as him for Halloween?
I did. And
yeah.
Here it is.
Yeah, we'll throw it out.
I think what we're going to look at, Jonathan, is Lewis's journey into self-acceptance and belonging and feeling like he belongs.
Yes.
Because he belonged the whole time, but like actually recognizing it in himself.
And if I may, your role here, I don't think Alan fully appreciates this movie, and I want him to see it through your eyes.
Okay.
If you love this movie, that's great. I have no problem with you. I have a problem with the movie, but that's not a judgment on you or me.
I mean, there's so many things in the world that can be improved. Just think of it. Moving sidewalks, flying cars. The possibilities are endless.
Flying cars. Yeah, that's a good one.
All it takes is some imagination and a little science, and we can make the world a better place.
Well, these are all interesting ideas. So, what's your favorite sport?
Well, doesn't anything come to your sport?
Actually...
Because I think I hit a home run with this one.
What is that?
First, a question. What's the number one problem that you face when you make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich?
Lewis, I don't think we...
Portion control. Too much peanut butter sticks to the roof of your mouth. Takes forever to chew. Too much jelly squishes out the sides and makes your hands all sticky.
That is true, actually.
Well, I propose that the perfect PB&J is within mankind's grasp. And I've built this machine to achieve it. For this demonstration, I'll use regular bread.
Honey, it's okay.
As you can see, toasting is an option.
We don't usually eat peanut butter.
Lewis, this is really not necessary.
Jam. Aiming a loaded gun at this guy.
I just love the hidden dad joke of it's jammed.
Yeah.
Oops.
Oh, that's terrifying.
This traumatized me as a child. I was like, what is going on?
Peanut allergy.
You can kill somebody with lunch food?
Let me get that off. Stand back.
A little gleam.
A little gleam. It's pretty good. Pretty good.
Breathe.
I'm so sorry, I didn't know.
It was really nice to meet you. We're gonna need some time to think about it.
Hi, folks, everything all right?
What happened?
Miss Duffy, that boy is definitely not right for us. Now, if you'll excuse me.
I'm so sorry about this. If you would just...
Oh, man. Okay.
That's tough.
Yeah. If Lewis were in my office and he were a teen and he were trying to get adopted, like, I would advise him to do exactly what he did, which is to show them exactly who he is.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Don't pretend to be something that you're not. And this is true for adoption. This is true for dating. This is true for finding your circle of friends. This is true for deciding what you want to do with your life professionally.
I mean, for building connection, right?
Like, yeah.
People connect with who you are, not the front you put up.
Right. Well, and or they might connect with the front you put up, but how long is that going to last?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's how long can you maintain the front?
Yeah.
You can't hold that up forever.
And so Lewis is doing exactly what he should do, which is he's geeking out about science and invention. And the moment the dad's like,
do you like sports?
Yeah, what's your favorite sport?
Sports. I don't like them.
I feel super called out because the dad looks exactly like me. And I love sports.
And I especially like when the potential adoptive mom says, that boy is not right for us. She didn't say what's wrong with that boy. She didn't say what a monster. She just said he's not right for us. And that's true.
She was still in an emotionally elevated place, but I still feel like that was like...
Right. Because she could have been a lot worse, and in a lot of movies, she would have been.
Yeah.
Right? But to Lewis, the reason it lands so hard is because she says he's not right for us. He hears, I'm not right for anybody.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's his core belief, right? I was abandoned by my mother. I don't belong anywhere.
And he's letting everything around him prove him right. I saw something, I forgot who said this. I always, I like see these quotes and then store them and then I regurgitate them, but I don't give credit. The quote was that fitting in is the opposite of belonging. And so Lewis is like, he had an option to be like, oh yeah, I love basketball. Like sports would have been like, I love sports. And like, he could have chosen to do that to try and connect with this guy. But like you say, the facade eventually will fall and then they'll see who you really are. And then everything you did was a lie. And that's not because who you are is unacceptable. It's because you presented that you weren't who you are.
Right.
And so I agree. Lewis did exactly what he should have done here. He didn't have the knowledge that that guy had a peanut allergy. It was just an unfortunate event. Like, that kind of stuff happens, and there's nothing that could be done about it.
The only thing I would have coached him with is some relaxation techniques, because he's getting worked up because it's not working, and he really wants them to accept him. He really wants them to see how great he is and his invention is, and he's not listening to, we don't eat peanuts. He's not paying attention to the cue of the dad standing up and, like, backing away.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, be yourself. And owning that, some people, it's not going to be a fit for. When you're at peace with that, then you can just show up as you. And if they don't like it, it's like, that's fine. I don't want to be with you anyway.
The Robinsons love to learn by doing.
Yes, they do.
They're big into STEM. They're doing science. They're doing engineering.
Yeah.
Lots of stuff. You know what they could have used?
Brilliant.
Today's episode is sponsored by Brilliant.
Brilliant is where you learn by doing, with thousands of interactive lessons in math, data analysis, programming, and AI.
Each lesson has tons of hands-on problem solving to help you play with concepts and really build understanding.
This hands-on approach is the most effective way to learn, and it helps you build problem solving skills and develop a powerful daily learning habit.
You know, we're both big fans of building positive daily habits.
And of self-improvement.
And this is a way that you can learn just a little bit every day. It's like bite-sized little nibbles.
It's like the pizza rolls of personal growth.
You don't want to eat an entire pizza of knowledge every day. Sometimes you just want to pop a couple of them into the toaster oven.
They've got a bunch of really awesome lessons.
So the one I'm currently working on is a Foundations of Logic course for programming. I'm trying to get a little bit back into programming. I have a video game idea.
Ooh.
And it's honestly really helpful. I'm learning all the flaws in the ways I've been thinking my entire life.
And they've got a bunch that Lewis would have loved, or maybe even created.
Like scientific thinking, where you have interactive lessons on scientific concepts from simple machines to Einstein's theory of relativity.
Or programming lessons like creative coding or thinking in code.
To try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, go to brilliant.org/cinematherapy or click the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Brilliant!
I made some lunch.
Not hungry.
Poor Mr. Harrington.
I killed him?
No. I didn't kill him. I called. He's perfectly fine.
Catastrophizing.
I was just gonna say that it's...
Look at you dropping the lingo.
To try a sandwich from that...
That's exactly what that is.
I pick up some stuff.
Wonderful.
It's not you. We just haven't found the right couple yet.
124.
What?
That's how many adoption interviews I've had. 124.
Oh, Lewis, come on now. You're exaggerating just to make your...
He pulled up the receipts.
I would be 13 next year. And you know how hard it is for a teenager to get adopted. I have no future. No one wants me.
That's not true, Lewis.
My own mother didn't even want me.
Now stop it. You do not know that.
Then why'd she give me up?
Ugh. Even though 124 people in the grand scheme of things is actually a super small sample size, that's his entire experience.
Yeah,
yeah, and for him, that's 100% of
yes,
people.
Yes, yes, 100% of the time he has been rejected. Unfortunately, he doesn't really have the tools to really process this because he's 12. Like, did you have the tools when you were 12? And it's just really sad to see him, like, get all down in the dumps and not, like, see himself as the, like, valuable, brilliant mind that he is. Mm. And just be so down on himself, and now I'm sad.
Well, he's been rejected 124 times. But even if that's the case, you know, in your life, who are you surrounded by? So for example, when I was in dating in college, right, really wanted to get married, so came off as really desperate and really pushy. And the thing is, there is nothing inherently unlovable about me, and there is nothing about me that says you can't have a healthy, satisfying relationship.
Right.
But my approach, because of the anxiety, was putting people off.
Yep.
And so if I'm in therapy with Lewis, it all comes down to, Lewis, you believe that this is happening because you're unlovable.
My project didn't work because I'm no good.
It's happening for two reasons. One, who you are is a perfect fit for a certain family, or for a lot of families. And two, you need to calm down. So let's talk about how to do that. So people can see it instead of being put off by, and I would guess the first few, he wasn't like this,
mm-hmm.
you know, but the more we get rejected, the more
that
we get
hurt. That is learned.
Yeah. After I got my heart broken twice, I think is when I really started, please love me. I mean, Helen, we were just talking about your dog has had two families before this family.
Yes.
And so he is constantly seeking love and reassurance.
He really needs validation.
I just met him today and he's the sweetest.
He is the sweetest, but he's always like, you still love me, right? And we laugh, but it's sad. Like, he's been through a lot, but, like, that's the energy. And the way we get through that energy, and I joked with you, well, I'm trying to teach Helen's dog, I'm trying to teach Gandalf self-love, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because, but that's how we get through the anxiety of please love me, please accept me, is when we're good with ourselves and we truly love ourselves, then we know what we have to offer, and then it's just a waiting game of just waiting to find the people who see what I already see.
And it's not so scary anymore. When you do the work, like the self-directed work, to actually like have a good relationship with yourself, because you can only be as nice to other people as you are to yourself. If you're being really mean to yourself, then yeah. you'll have to like put up a front and yeah. be like, look how nice I am. And then
you're,
when that falls.
You're being nice, not kind, mm-hmm. right?
Nice is different than good.
Good people do good even when they're not getting what they want.
Yes.
And then nice people, when they don't get what they want, they're like, okay, well now I'll show you who I really am.
Yeah, it's absolutely true.
Stupid!
In all these decades, they still didn't get it worked out.
Yep,
huh?
We're just...
He's completely changed the entire planet, but he still can't figure out peanut butter and jam.
My friend Lewis is an inventor. He can fix it.
Oh, Rory, you know I can't.
Oh, come on. Give it a try.
You don't understand what's at stake here. Uncle Joe's seen the toast.
Is that Shatner? Because it
no,
sounds like Shatner.
It's Patrick Warburton.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
We all pay.
I don't know.
What is with the uncle who's going to die if he doesn't get his food?
He's seen the toast, dude.
Exciting letter rip, Lewis.
Quickly. Uncle Joe can't hold on much longer.
He's too much sucking his thumb.
PB&J withdrawals are insane.
I've always said that.
Should have bought Uncrustables.
No, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You failed!
And it was awesome.
He was totally shaming himself there.
I did better!
From failing, you learn. From success, not so much.
If I gave up every time I failed, I never would have made the meatball cannon.
I never would have made my fireproof pants. Still working out the kinks.
Like my husband always says...
Growth mindset core.
Yeah. I love this whole scene.
I love that.
I really want to be annoyed by that. I really do. But then the music cutting out and him opening a fortune cookie and it starts up the music again.
Joyous whimsy. This is what we love.
Okay, so I'm gonna let you be the therapy co-pilot here. I'm gonna give you the controls, because you impressed me when you dropped catastrophizing.
Yes!
So you're talking about growth mindset. Tell me what you're seeing in this scene.
So right there, when the mistake happened.
Bryson, take the wheel.
Take it from my hand.
Oh my gosh.
Whoa.
I feel like we were separated at birth, but you are the cooler one, but I'm cool with that. That's fine. Did we just become best friends?
Yes!
Four! I've got four now.
I'm fourth.
Stop.
So when the mistake happened, Lewis went immediately to shame. And shame is, I hate it. It's bad. Don't do that. Guilt is good. You've talked about this.
Yeah.
So guilt serves a purpose. It like, oh, I did something wrong. I need to improve here. And then when you do, you have to let go of it.
Yeah.
So guilt says, I did bad. Shame says, I am bad to my core. That's what he's doing there. He's like, oh, I'm so sorry. Like, I ruined it. Oh, geez. And then Lewis struggles throughout the movie with a little bit of a fixed mindset. It's like, he literally says, I have no future.
Yeah.
And that's so sad for a child to say that. But it's so nice to see him finally be surrounded by people who understand that and can, like, lift him into that and, like, show him, like, it's okay. Like,
yeah.
Everyone is human. Everyone screws up. None of y'all are Jesus. And you're going to mess up. It's how you learn from it. It's how you apply the knowledge you've learned. And I've been, like, definitely working on myself a lot these past several years to get to the point where I'm very self-critical without being mean to myself.
We've done this in our cinema therapy meetings. I've done this with our therapy team over at Mended Light, where we celebrate failure, right? Where it's part of the conversation of, okay, what was your failure this week and what did you learn from it? And I think we might have stole it from this
movie. yeah, for real. There, you bring value to the table. So that's something about getting, like, rejected is, they don't really see it in you, and that's okay as long as you see it in yourself. And then once you become more self-assured, then that gets projected out more, and then more people get attracted to you.
Testify.
I preach.
If you'd like to see a whole lot more of this, including a lot more of Bryson and Jono geeking out about each other, you can check out our extended ad-free director's cut on our Patreon. We have there's other stuff too, but
it's in there.
Early ad-free director's cuts that are really long and they're good.
Aha! Allow me to shed some light on the subject.
Traumatizing to me.
I love his
my old room.
I hate everything about him. But that's okay. That's my problem.
yes, it is I, Mike Yagubian!
Mike Yagubian!
Did you see his belly jiggle?
Yes.
But one learns to love it.
How'd you end up like this?
Well, it's a long and pitiful story about a young boy with a dream of winning a Little League championship.
Like, where he goes from a sleepy, sad little kid to, like, a mustache-twirling villain from the 1930s, I don't know, but...
We lost by one run because of me.
Get him! If I hadn't fallen asleep, I would have caught the ball, and we would have won! Do you understand?
For some reason, no one wanted to adopt me.
Wizkid Cornelius Robinson graduates from college...
Crazy bags under his eyes, little goob, is... maybe my favorite character in this movie.
What's up? Cool binder.
Hey, Goop, want to come over to my house today?
They all hated me. Eventually, they closed down the orphanage and everyone left. Except me.
Cornelius Robinson, rebuilds inventor.
Robinson.
This is what fixed mindset does to an MF. This is why you don't do this.
I realized it wasn't my fault. It was yours. If you hadn't kept me up all night working on your stupid project, then I wouldn't have missed the catch. So I devised a brilliant plan to get by.
The tongue. Whoever animated that needs to be banned from the animation guild.
Jail immediately.
You're going to animation jail. I'm sorry.
Goob is such a caricature of, like, what can go wrong if you're applying what happens in your life in a non-healthy way.
Right.
Yeah. And literally after this scene, like, Lewis is like, but I didn't force you to stay in the abandoned orphanage. I didn't force you to just sit here and fester and, like, never progress in life and never do anything. Like, Goob had such a small opinion of himself that he let that one failure stunt him for life. And then directly after this, Goob goes, take accountability for my life or blame you. Ding, 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 ding. think blame you wins hands down.
I think the reason for that is it's scary to take ownership. I mean, when you finally step into it, it's liberating and exciting because then you can create, if not exactly the life you want, because there's other factors, but you can create who you want to be, right? Mm-hmm. That's something you can control.
You can take, yes, exactly. You can take control of that. He's focusing on something he can't control, and that's a recipe to be miserable.
Not because others' behaviors don't influence us or impact our lives, but just because if I'm waiting for them to fix it, I'll be waiting a long time, which is exactly what he did. Mm-hmm. Instead of thinking like, well, even if this is somebody else's fault, the only person who's going to take the wheel of my life is me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, everybody, it's been a long, hard day filled with emotional turmoil and dinosaur fights. So why don't you all hit the hay and Lewis and me will get going.
Oh, do you have to go now? I mean, you know, it's getting late. Maybe Lewis could spend the night.
Mom, she's maybe so some other time, okay?
Well, anytime you want to come over, you just come over.
Mom.
The truth is, we love having you.
We really have to go.
No. No, you don't. You have to stay.
All I ever wanted.
It would be a better family for you than us. What do you say, Lewis? Do you want to be a Robinson? You want to adopt me?
I love it when you do that.
It's so sad. It's so sad because right after this, Wilbur knocks off Lewis's hat and they see his hair and they realize that Lewis, like in the future,
is the dad.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. He is the husband.
So, like,
and the
you
father
have to go back in order to become that.
Yeah.
And so he's getting a glimpse at what he's going to be in the future, and that's what pushes him to keep moving forward.
Yeah.
And there's a scene in here where old Lewis talks to young Lewis and tries to instill some of the beliefs that, like, have helped him get to this point. It's like, it's all up to you, but, like, you can do this because we are a pretty smart kid.
Yeah.
And I think I really love that, like, when an older version of a character gets to talk to the younger version and instill some of the stuff that helped them get to where they are.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's super sweet.
But the fact is, like, whoever you are, you've got your people, even if you haven't found them yet. You have worth. You have something to contribute.
Yep.
And if people aren't seeing it, yeah, maybe you need to slow your roll a little bit. and for me, doing that was coming to really love myself. And then I could just be at peace and calm, right?
Yes.
Until I found my people. And it's going to be the same thing for you.
The stuff that you're talking about should be taught in schools. I don't know why we do math for 12 years and into college, and the classes that teach you how to be a good partner and be a good parent are optional. Sorry, yeah. I have feelings
no,
about
No, I have feelings on that too. And some people say, well, I don't ever want to get married and I don't ever want to have kids. Okay, but actually basic relationship skills and mental and emotional health skills, I think that would be a wonderful investment for our society.
Mm-hmm.
How much smoother would so many things go?
Yes, yeah, because unless you're having zero relationships in your life, like Goob, then you're going to want to know that.
Until then, we're just going to crank out YouTube videos. Hope you enjoy them.
So, Bryson, for those who are, like, just meeting you for the first time, what's your channel? Where can they find you on socials? What's your whole deal?
So, yeah, I do storytime animation. You can find me at Haminations on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
And,
choice.
Yeah, do funny animated stories, and, yeah, that's me.
Really, really recommend you check it out. So much fun. So, until next time,
keep moving forward.
Take accountability for my own life or blame you. Ding, 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 ding. Blame you wins hands down.
It's a caffeine patch. I can stay awake for days with no side effects. Ah!
And watch movies. And go to therapy.
We want to thank our patrons for supporting us. People with names like
Nikki.
Okay, Big Red Cube. I want to meet that guy.
John Fowler.
Ash Wolf.
And Monique Nicole. What's up?
All right.
I feel like Big Red Cube and Ash Wolf are both characters in a D&D campaign.
I would play that.
Yeah.
Thank you. We love you.